In this video, we will show you how to create scalloped edge corners to add a retro and elegant finish to your projects. Use this technique to elevate plain cloth napkins, perfect for spring dinners with loved ones. Let's get started. First, we set up our workspace for precision. Go to View menu and enable the grid. This will help us align everything perfectly. Now we will design a right angle corner to represent the napkin edge. Start the Outline Shape tool. Hold the Alt and Shift keys down so that the cursor snaps on the closest point of the grid. Move the cursor 13 cm along the X axis and add a cusp node to the corner. Now move 13 cm upwards on the Y axis and finish the line while holding the Alt and Shift keys. Select this line and right-click to create another border. In the dialog box, check to the outside. Set the distance to 12 mm. Make sure the stitch type is running and press OK. Now, let's shape the scallop edge. Start the node editor. While pressing the Shift key down, select the upper and the corner nodes. Press the Num plus key to add a midpoint node to each line. Press the Num plus key two more times to create evenly spaced nodes along the new segment. Delete the two nodes before and after the corner to ensure that the middle curve is larger. Select the remaining newly added nodes one by one while holding the Ctrl key down. Right-click to convert those nodes to cusp nodes. Select the smooth nodes from that side, holding the Ctrl key down, and convert them to auto-smooth. Move the nodes vertically using the arrow keys of your keyboard, or press the Alt key and drag to meet the napkin edge. Do the same for the other side. Select the smooth nodes, holding the Ctrl key down, convert them to auto-smooth, and move them to touch the napkin edge. Continue by converting the cusp corner line to auto-smooth. As you can see, the curve is created automatically. For a smooth transition, move the end nodes of the scallop design so they connect seamlessly with the napkin side and create a curve. Do the same for the other side too. We will use the outer line to place the napkin on the hoop and the scallop line to cut the new design. Duplicate this line to add a satin finishing. From the properties, set the type to satin serial and the width to 3 mm. Right-click and convert the outline to object. Now, set the fill to satin. To give the finishing a beautiful effect, start the node editor to adjust the middle node of each curve so the thickness varies, making the center slightly thicker than the edges. Adjust the endpoints so the satin fades out smoothly. Do the same for the other ending too. Now, let's decorate the napkin. From the Tools bar, select the Insert Clipart. In the Clipart Library dialog box, type the word Corner to find the decorative corner motifs. I will use the Corners 11 Clipart. Select the motif of your choice and press Insert. Click and drag the cursor diagonally, holding the Shift key down, to place it perfectly on the corner. Now that we have placed the motif, we can disable the grid view by pressing the combination of Control, Shift, and G keys to get an uncluttered working space. Select the motif. Right-click to convert the shape to red work. Change the stitch's style to beam cap stitch to achieve a handmade look. Now, let's switch to manual mode to double-check the sequence. Move the satin line before the motif. First, we want the corner outline, then the cutting line, the satin scalloped finishing, and last, the decorative motif. I will change the color of the cutting scallop line as a trick for the machine to stop before and after the line to give me time to adjust before moving forward. Since we're keeping the design monochromatic, let's set the same color for the satin border and the decorative motif. To ensure that the satin stitch fully covers the napkin's cut edge, let's make a couple of adjustments. Select the cutting line, add the node at the beginning and create a small corner to secure that point. Now, select the satin scalloped line to extend it slightly past the cutting line for a seamless finish. Do the same for the other side too. Start the slow redraw. Everything seems to be in the right order. Select the proper hoop for the design and let's get to make it. Before moving to the embroidery part, go to Print, select Design Only, and save a printout of the design. For this project, we will need a hoop, a napkin, stabilizer, a printout of the design, and thread of your choice. Before we begin embroidering, let's prepare the napkin corner. For a clean finish, rip the seam of the area where you're about to embroider. To do so, use the printout of the design to mark the exact points where the stitches meet the scalloped finishing on each side. Use a seam ripper, but leave about 3 cm of the thread uncut. We need some thread length uncut to tie a small knot to secure the stitches from fraying. Since the embroidery will be visible from both sides, use the same thread for the bobbin as the top thread for a crisp professional look. Now let's hoop a piece of stabilizer. You may use some tearaway stabilizer for a clean finish, but I recommend water-soluble stabilizer. Now, let's move to the embroidery part. Load the design to the machine. Attach the hoop to your machine and start embroidering the placement stitch to guide you with the napkin's positioning. Use adhesive spray on the back of the napkin. Carefully place the napkin corner inside the placement lines. Now the machine will stitch the line that will help us cut the excess fabric from the napkin's edges to create the scallop design. Once this is done, remove the hoop from the machine and carefully cut along the scalloped line. Be precise to ensure a clean, satin border later on. Place the hoop back to the machine. Now, let me share a useful tip. Adding a water-soluble film on top helps smooth out the fraying edges and gives a polished finish. Continue with a satin stitch that will cover the edges of the scallop design. Now, let's finish with a decorative motif. Once this is done, remove the hoop from the machine and take out the embroidered napkin. Remove the film from the top. Now it's time to trim the excess stabilizer from the design. In case you use water-soluble stabilizer, rinse it away with water. And here we have it! A beautifully embroidered napkin with scalloped edges and a decorative motif. You may experiment with different color combinations to match your decor. Here we use various lavender shades for an elegant touch. Want to personalize it even more? Add a festive message, like Happy Easter, or a monogram for each of your guests, perfect for a special celebration. These customized napkins will make your spring table setting truly unique. Do share with us your embroidered designs and don't forget to follow us for more.